Okay, so the first thing I'm going to talk about real quick is my on-the-go sales. And I do have, I personally have a sale bag. This is just a 31 bag that I got personalized a long time ago, probably when 31 first started. I've had a long time. And then in my sale bag, I have the little clear, or you could use the black bags that come, the mesh bags. And I take things out of the box, okay? So the nail polishes I take out of the box. And I take like discontinued or limited edition that I might have got too many of. I take things out of the boxes so people can see them. And then I just have a demo. Like if I have a lot of things I want to sell, I'll have one of each demo. I don't do a lot with samples, like on-the-go sales, temptation basket, things like that. You want to invest in a full-size set of each for samples. And then if people want to try it, they can try it. When you get home at the end of the day, you can just wipe them down with a little alcohol wipe. You always put the product on their fingers and let them try it. You never let them try it on their lips or anything like that. So that's basically what I do for on-the-go sales. I have things that are discontinued, like the Step 2 microderms. I haven't taken them out of the box yet. Anything that's discontinued, and I do have like a full-size microderm, or things that I have too many of on my shelf, I'll stick in my sale bag, like perfumes or whatever. And then on the side, I might have a few lip glosses. These were from the Beauty That Counts campaign. Always take things out of the boxes because the eye buys what the eye sees. And then the word sale indicates that it's on sale. And I don't want you to feel like you have to discount your product because you don't. Even if you take 50 cents off the price, if it makes you feel better that you are having a sale, it could be $13 instead of $14. They don't know what the real price is. Unless they're like your really good customers or whatever, something like that. So, and then I have the cream eyeshadows I always take out of the box. These expire, and I have some that are close to being expired. So this is basically what I do, and I will carry this around with me when I'm at work. It's an advantage. I can put it like this if I need to because it's my purse. Right? Or if I'm strutting through the HUD cafeteria where there's like 50 women sitting down eating and I'm walking through the cafeteria and this bag catches their attention. And then I'll just walk up to a table of people like this that I know. I mean, if you work with people, you know it's easier. And I just say, ladies, I have some really good stuff on sale today. What do y'all need? You need lip gloss for your purse? You need some mascara? Like I sold all my mascaras at the beach. I sold like 30 mascaras, so I don't even have any in here. Everybody will buy a mascara and lip gloss. And you just tell them, you know, we have amazing products. You wear the products. You have to wear the products to be able to speak to the products. Okay, so that's a little bit about my on-the-go sales. Now, for the holiday pack, the holiday things that are out now, I just want to say that this year is one of the best. I've been a consultant for 8 years. This is one of the cutest, simplest, eye-catching. We, like this is competition with Bath & Body Works. None of my customers or friends will be buying anything from Bath & Body Works this year because we have this. And you can dress it up. So for the simple things, like say you're brand new and you have nothing and you can't go buy anything, you can buy a roll of tulle like this. Okay, just one roll of tulle. We'll wrap about 100 of these. And that's it. And you have your demo for them to try. So for those of you that are having an open house, you could have a one full size set and then have a whole bunch of these wrapped, right? And they get to try it and then they can buy it. So for like our Skin Vigorate brush, I sold every single one of these that I took to the beach and mailed that many more because everybody wanted this. Everybody. And I didn't bring my one I have, but I have one in a bag like this open with the head on it and the batteries in it so they can try it on their hand. Every single one of these I took to the beach sold. Of course, not with the bow and the ribbon. But for those of you that are brand new and you may not have money to invest in packaging, you can go and buy a bag of bows for like whatever, $1, $2, and a roll of ribbon. And I have my rolls of ribbon. You could even buy rolls of ribbon like this. You could buy your roll of ribbon like this, one silver, one gold, whatever. And you could wrap your box up like this and you can market it. I sell a lot in Applebee's. It's like my spot I go to. On the way, Applebee's Thursday night's karaoke. I've been going there for like 6 years. And I will walk in with some of these and sell every single one, because to tell you, men are the easiest to sell to, because they can buy for their mom, their wife, their sister, their daughter, whoever, right? Men do not like to shop in the mall, and men like to score brownie points. And if you go, this is me, I'm not saying you have to do this, I do this. I go into a bar full of men watching a football game or a baseball game. They're drinking, they're having fun with their friends, and they're thinking, oh my gosh, I'm gonna have to go to the mall tomorrow. I don't wanna go to the mall. Men don't like to go to the mall. You can sell anything to a man. These and these, I'm telling you, you could sell. And so that's what I do. Okay, the other thing I'll show you is the miracle set. My daughter made this for me to show you guys. This is only the company packaging with a bag and a bow. That's it. And you could add shred if you want. You could add the little miniature ornament balls if you want to, but you don't have to. If your bow is nice enough, you can pull it off, okay? And that's just the standard miracle set packaging. The other thing you could do is the time-wise repair. And I'll tell you about my bags and my bows when I'm finished. But the time-wise repair, in a cello bag, this packaging is amazing by itself. Like, you don't even have to dress it up. Like, I'm not even gonna put shred in there because I want them to see what it is, because that's eye-catching. It's very good packaging, our time-wise repair set is. And then you can just get these pull bows. I would get the biggest one you can find for the time-wise repair. And basically, once you, I'll just open one and show you how to do the pull bow. I thought, oh, here's one right here. Okay, so imagine the difference. This is the big one. You want the biggest one you can find for the time-wise repair, right? So basically the way the pull bows work is you can buy them. I'll tell you when and where to buy them. And it's like so easy. Like, you can just have a bow like that in like 2 seconds. But for this big bag, you want the bow to be bigger, because what you want is the wow factor. You want the eye buys what the eye sees. And with men, if it looks pretty and they think their wife is going to like it because it looks good, they don't care what's in there. They don't. Because what do they need? Brownie points. And they don't want to go to the mall. But a bow like that would be cool in that size package, right? Okay, so the microderm, this is our new microderm abrasion set. And can I just tell you what I love about this? It's a flat box. You know what I mean? Like, you don't have to take the lid. You can take the lid off to see it. It's presentable. So I just happen to stick some shred in there. These are the Mary Kay bags that are on MK Connections. I got mine at Seminar because I don't pay shipping ever. And you can get a roll of ribbon and 50 bags, very, very, very affordable, and just do like this. And you could use this color scheme for any holiday. Okay, so reach out to your customers if you have customers for the skincare, because if our customers love our skincare, which they do, they're gonna buy it for their relatives. You know, maybe I'll buy one for my sister or my daughter or whatever. One of my favorites, I sold all of these last year, and this is a company idea, I can't take credit for it. It's called thebalm.com, and it's earbuds, ponytail holders, and the tinted lip balm, or you could do the little eyeliners, but I added a portable charger thing to mine because everybody has them now, and the teenagers love them. You know, even grown women love them. So I sold every single one of those I had last year. If you can't, like, again, I'm trying to give you ideas for people that may not have a lot of packaging, you can take out of the box a mascara and an eye makeup remover, ponytail holders and earbuds. Ponytail holders and earbuds. Everybody loves that. And I just stuck this bow on there. I really don't like it. I'll probably put a different type of bow on there, but you really don't have to. Like, even without the bow, it's like cute. Like, this could be a teacher gift, a daycare gift. It could be a gift for women at the bus stop. You know, people like to buy each other gifts, right? And then you could do something as simple as a box of our perfume in a bag with a ribbon. These are my girlfriend's house bags that I only get at Seminar and Career Conference because I don't like to pay shipping. So I get one or two packs every time I go to Career Conference or Seminar. And you can get these little balls at like Five Below. a whole bag of them. Very inexpensive. You don't even need the balls if you just want to put some shred. Shred's a lot cheaper than decorations. Like this shred, this little bit of shred here, if you pull it apart nice and neat, this bag will last me a couple of years. Okay, just to give you an example. Now, if you want to sell, Satin Hands is a really good seller. Men will buy Satin Hands for everyone on their list. Sorry, I was just a little unorganized, but let me just show you what I'm talking about. You can take the bag that the Satin Hands, this is not my idea, this is Christian Schneider, she's in our national area. You can take the bag, and my daughter did this for me, and you can just, you know what, I save my peanuts that my orders come in, because I don't like the newspaper. So I fill it up with peanuts, and it'll raise up the product like so, and then you just dress it up. This is the bag that comes in our Satin Hands, like you just fold it down. You're not spending money. You might be buying a roll of ribbon. Like, that's all that is. It's just a roll of ribbon, and you can dress it up. Now, if you want to, you can stick it in one of these bags and put a bow on it, but you don't need to. As long as they're in here secure, and you just tape the stuff up with tape. I use this kind of tape. You just make like a big, long roll and just wrap it around inside there and put some shred. The shred will stick to the tape, so they won't see it. Okay, another thing that sold really, really well is the hand cream and the gloves. Okay, so I used to stress over ribbon to tie it up to hold it. I don't anymore. I use ponytail holder. Okay, and it doesn't even have to match. But you can put your hand cream in one of the gloves. You can secure it, and then you can just take one of these little pull bows. And I'll show you. These I get at NashvilleWraps.com, and I do have to pay shipping for those, but I order in bulk. Because, and I'm not saying you have to order in bulk this year, you know, you can build up as you go. But these little bows right here come in all colors, and I recommend getting a variety pack. And it's just a cute little bow like that. And you could wrap it around. I use these strings, the edges, a lot to tie stuff. And you could just stick it there. And I put this candy cane in to show you, but I use real candy canes when I can buy them for the hand cream and the gloves. These you can sell to anyone. Teachers, daycare center workers, anyone. I mean, people will buy for them, is what I'm saying. And then I also have the socks. Everyone loves fuzzy socks and our foot cream. And I didn't have any of these already made because I sell a lot of these. I probably sold 50 of these last year. So I would definitely, and this is inexpensive. Like, you can order a lot of these and it would go a long way. So if you're trying to max out your double credit and you really don't have a lot, like, you're not gonna be able to sell all this stuff, make it and go out and sell it in the next 3 days, let's be real. But what you can do, you can make an initial investment in the next 3 days. If you take a little bit of your money, you have to make an investment to get a return. Does that make sense? Like, if you purchase some products now, you're gonna get the double credit, which is gonna help you towards your quota sales. It's gonna help your unit. And then this will pay you as you go. You can go for the next 6 weeks and make all your money back, plus it's unlimited. Like, these are $5.50, you know what I mean? And then the hand creams. Another big hit were these, the little bread bowls, like AC Moore and Michaels has these. You could use a coupon and get one half off, and it will cost you 50 cents. You put the Satin Hands in there and you secure it, right? And you put it in a bag with a bow and a little bit of shred. I sold every single one of these last year. Okay, you can add a couple dollars for your packaging if you want. So if a Satin Hands is 35 and you have a bow and a bag and a thing, whatever that thing is called, you can add a few dollars so you're not out of pocket and you're not rolling in your profits. Now for men, if you want to sell things, I just buy blue bags. Okay, this one's a little ratty because it's old. I didn't have time to fix it up, but you can put one of our aftershaves. And what I do is I take stuff out of the box. So, like, you could take this out of the box and fill the box up with the peanuts and tape this to the box. And you could even do that and just put a blue or a black bow around it. You could take, say you had a, let's say this is like a gift card, a Dick's Sporting Goods or a Bass Pro Shop, $5 gift card, $10 gift card, whatever the person wants to spend. You could have like, this is your gift card, this is your product, put it in a bag and a little bow, right? So we have nice affordable gifts for men. And these bags are from my girlfriend's house. I just got blue ones. Also for men, these are from last year. I need to spruce this up a little bit. It's been in my basement. But I sold a lot of these last year. It's a beer koozie or soda koozie. It's the bag and a bow, and then it's the men's shaving cream. You could even fit one of the eye creams, or you could fit an aftershave in there with it, or you could put a little disposable razor in there with it. Put some peanuts in the koozie, and it'll lift up the shaving cream. Another big hit I had one year when we had the pedicure sets. Mm-hmm. These baskets are at Michael's, or I'm sorry, ladies. Y'all can all look at this stuff. I'm not going to pack it up right away. These baskets I get at Michael's for half off. The after Christmas sales, and some Michael's have sales before Christmas, 60% off baskets, 40% off baskets. Just buy a couple. Just buy a couple. You can package stuff like this. And something that I always use, I use the, I thought I had my stuff set up in a nice way for you guys, but I use picks. Okay, a pick. You can add a pick to something, right? Like this has the red pick in it. You see the red pick there? You can add a pick and a little bit of shred, and these are really cheap. You can buy these very inexpensive. Another big seller were these containers. These containers are in Target. I think they're $1.50. Okay, and you could put a satin hands in there. You could fix it up with some type of eye set. You could add a lip gloss, maybe something like that. These, every single one of them I had sold. And I always buy my stuff for the following year after Christmas when it's on sale. Another big hit was this. This basket last year, I think I did 20 of them. And I tried to go back and get more and couldn't because they were sold out. I saved this one. This basket, I sold every single one of them that I had. Some of them I had miracle sets in, and some of them I have satin hand sets in. You could do satin hands and satin lips. You just put it in the bag, you add some shred and a pick, and you add a bow. That was a big hit. This was a cute idea I got from my director several years ago. We had these cute little holiday boxes. Some of you that have been in like me might still have some. And Tanya taught me that. She put the satin lips on the front with no boxes, and I just filled this up with peanuts and put a little ornament of some sort on there. And she sold these one day. She sold like 40 of these in a parking lot of a Dunkin' Donuts. No lie. Tanya and I, we go out every year and sell stuff together. So I would recommend you pick up things where you are, and where, like these are in the dollar store, the earbuds with the portable charger, dollar store. Pick them up once in a while when you're out. These little bows, I think, came from wherever. There's like 12 bows in there. And I got these ponytail holders, buy one, get one half off at Charming Charlie's. And if you wanted to stretch it longer, just don't put so many on there. Like I like a lot of colors, so I put like 5 or 6. But you could put 2 or 3 and stretch your dollars, you know, stretch your investment. And then these I thought were cute. My daughter did these last year. We took a nail file from Five Below, 2 of the colors of nail polish, couple ponytail holders, and a pick. Like you could sell this for $20, no lie, all day long. Men will buy these. Mostly all of these I sold last year were to men that have daughters, nieces. Right? Okay, and then you have your bigger items, like say you're going for the wow factor, right? Let's say, oh, this was one of my favorites too, a little basket like this with the body lotion and the perfume, but you take the perfume out of the box and you put the box down in there. I don't see my box, but say you had your box, your perfume box, you would just put the perfume on top of it. You know what I mean? Because it raises it up. and it's filler. It looks like there's more stuff in the basket, so it's more appealing. That these baskets were big sellers, very big sellers, and they're very inexpensive. I've done these. These, I think, came from like Target somewhere. I don't remember, but I put the hydrating lotion and the body wash and shave. You could put it in here. These are like a dollar. Okay, put it in a bag and tie it up with a string, put a bow on it. You could even open this and hang it from the outside with the bow, like the loofah thingy, right? I've sold a lot of those before. And the number one seller also is the coffee mug with the hand cream. You put it in a bag and you add a bow. Okay, so let me tell you guys about my bags and my bows, because I use the best bags. You can try to find little less expensive bags or cheaper bags, but they're not gonna hold up, trust me. These came from Mary Kay Connections. They're very nice, MK Connections. If you don't have money to invest in these, because they do cost a little more, you could use anything. You could use a My Girlfriend House bag that's red, that you might already have. You put a little bit of shredding in it. You tie it up with one of these little mini pull bows, right? You could even use, say you have satin lips. You could get these little stockings like the dollar store, dress them up, or you could just take the satin lips, put them in your goodie bags or your business card bags that you already have, and use one of the pull bows that I showed you, the little pull bow. I don't know where it is, but it would be really cute with just the pull bow. I mean, look at this. This is just ribbon. You know what I mean? If the ribbon matches, there's a lot of places you can get ribbon. Another big seller was this box. My daughter talked me into buying these, and I told her I don't want to buy them because I thought they looked cheesy. Every single one of them sold. You could do the men's set. What she did, my daughter makes a lot of these for me now. I pay her. But she did an eye makeup remover and a mascara and an at play in the front and packaged it up cute with the ribbon and a bow. And guys buy these for their wives, their daughters. Okay, now I'm gonna show you something very inexpensive. This is just a little at play eye crayon and a color quad. It's like a little lollipop. I wrapped it up with a ponytail holder and a bow. Like seriously. These bags, you can get at AC Moore. Mm-hmm. You can get a whole pack of them. Lollipop bags in the cake decorating section. Mm-hmm. There's like 100 bags for like $2. Yeah. And if you use a half off coupon, like seriously, these bags are like less than a penny a piece. And then the ponytail holder. And if you don't want to do a $20, say you just want a $10, you might only have a bunch of eye quads. You can just use a lollipop stick, which is in the same section of AC Moore and Michaels with the candy bags, and there are 100 lollipop sticks, and I just tape it, and then put the bag over top of it, right? Let's see, my bags come from these bags. Okay, they have small, medium, and large. The very first year I joined Mary Kay, we went to Dare to Dream in Ocean City. Pam brought a lady named Julie, and she owns a business called Shop Dress Up Boutique. She also now owns something else that the directors see every year. I saw her at leadership when I went to leadership in New Orleans. But she still has her website just for these bags. The business that she had with these bags, she has shut down because she's moved on to a bigger business. And I wish I could think of the name of it, but I can't. But she kept her website open just to sell these bags. That's how popular they are. If you buy in bulk like I do, I buy 100 in a pack, they're like $20, and you could even split it. If four of you wanted to get some for this holiday season, you could each put up $5, you could each put up a little bit of shipping, and you'd each have 25 bags. I mean, you can be strategic like that. These are the best bags on the market, I'm not even gonna lie. These are the best. I never run out of these. I have people that call me and ask me for my bags because they forgot to order theirs. It's like, seriously.
Don't call Jim for bags.
Yeah. Okay, and then my bows.
What's the name of the company?
It's Julie with shopdressupboutique.com. And I have a picture of it on my phone. I can post it on Sisters in Pink. Okay, this is Julie. She owns a bigger business now, but she kept her website open just for these bags. No lie. Okay, my pull bows. These are the best. I'll let y'all feel them. These are matte finish These are nice bows. Like, you cannot destroy this bow. Seriously, it is nice. I mean, look at it. It's like so nice. These bows come from NashvilleWraps.com. Mm-hmm. And I typically order in bulk. I get a, when I do an order, I do an order. I get the small, I get the medium, I get the large, all colors, all finish. This is a ribbon finish. This is a matte finish. Because you're gonna need bows like this, like the gold, because girl, we don't want to make a men's gift set with like pink or purple, right? So you could do gold. I sold a lot of these. These I got from Five Below, Dick's Sporting Goods. A lot of 7-Elevens sell these. A lot of liquor stores sell these, but they're a little more pricey. If you go to Dick's with like a 20% off coupon and just get a couple of each team, and these sell. And I'll tell you what, when I go to the bar and the guys are all sitting there, and they don't want to go to the mall, but they want to earn brownie points. They can't go home empty-handed, right? I put a lady's hand cream or a foot cream in there, and I dress it up that way. Like I would put a blue bow or a pick. You could add a pick to it, and you could put a different color bow, and they'll buy them for their lady friends or wives or whatever. It doesn't always have to be the men. I sold every single one of these I had with hand cream in it. But there's lots of things that you can do. You just have to be creative. Something like this. You could put a hand cream and a foot cream and wrap it up. And you could sell it for $25 or whatever. Okay, and what I do for my, here's my notes. Okay, so I did on the go. Always have a full size set of demo. I talked about the men. Customers. Okay, so some of you might just want to deal with your customers this year. You can call your customers. Don't text them. Don't email them. Call them. And you're going to tell them, I'm doing 15-minute drive-by stop and shops. I would love to come over and show you all of the holiday things I have. And you can do your holiday shopping with me from the comfort of your home. So I book her for a time. Tuesday, 6 o'clock, great. I'll be there. It's only going to take 15 minutes to 30 minutes. I promise I won't keep you a long time. I'm going to bring lots of things for you to look at. You can pick out some things you like. You can pay half now, and then you pay the other half when I bring the products to you finished. Because what is that doing? It's giving you your money to order the product. Okay? And then I tell them, once I get them booked, I tell them, if you want to have a couple friends join you, I'll let you do your shopping at a discount. You think they're going to have some friends, right? Because they want to have a discount. Because one, you're already selling the sizzle of this appointment by coming to them and offering them a discount if they want to have a couple friends join them. But what's going to happen is you're going to meet their husband, probably. Then you're going to know him for future. You're going to meet their kids. You know, you could book their daughters for a makeover. It's endless possibilities. And the other thing I want to show y'all is, now over where Jen is, okay, before I show y'all that, you may work with people that work all the time. Let's say you have a man in your office that works all the time. He's always there. He might be the boss. He might be the CEO. He's always there. You know he needs to earn some brownie points with his wife, because he's always at work. He doesn't have time to go to the mall. You could sell what Tanya taught me a few years ago is the 12 days of Christmas. Now, I personally don't rock with this special because I do this, but there might be some of you that work. BG&E, you work at BG&E. There's tons of guys there. Those people never go home. My husband worked at Petco. They never go home. You could try to put together, like over there where Jen is, this 12 days of Christmas. Y'all can look at it when you go out. And basically what that is, you can sell them in $200, $300, $400 versions. Just, we can talk more about that later. We have information out there. I'm not going to go over all of it right now. But let's say that top box, I'll use this as an example. Because I sell a lot of these to guys in my office because I can sneak it in the door and I'm not lugging and breaking my neck on the metro. Right? These all go inside of each other just like that does. So if you're going to sell something like this, something like the 12 days, you would have to literally make an appointment with him, maybe to get it to his house, like when his wife's not home, if you feel comfortable doing that. But you set it up, you build it up, and you tie a big bow around it, you know, then The object is that she can open one gift a day. Something like this would just be Christmas morning. Or, like, the top box is always so little. It could be his own gift. People have done engagement rings in this top box. It could be anything. You know what I mean? And then the other part of that, too, is you could, I lost my train of thought for the 12 days of Christmas. That's like a wow gift. That's like, say, it could be maybe some of y'all's dads would buy it for your mom. You never know. And what I tell people is, I tell everyone, I give them my business card, everyone that buys for me, I give them my business card, and I tell them, I offer a 100% money back guarantee. Anything you buy from me, if your wife doesn't like it, your girlfriend, whoever, the person you're giving it to doesn't like it, call me. I will exchange it or give you a refund. I tell people that because that's what we offer. That's what we offer. So I tell people that. And then the other thing I do is this year we have, and it's not too late to do this. I just did this a few days ago. I picked a few of my really, well, actually, I sent this out. I think this was the PCP. But people, like, let's say your sister, you don't have her on your PCP, but you know she has a lot of people to buy gifts for. You can mail her one of these, or you can give her one of these, and have her just look through it. There's a lot of things that we have. But I'm going to strongly encourage you to do this. This will sell. This will sell. I'm going to encourage you to do... Yep, that's it.
Because in malls, they're like $99.
That's right.
And this,
yep. And you're offering a money-back guarantee if they don't like it. If you say that to people, they know you're sincere and they trust you. Let's be clear. People are going to buy from you because they like you. If they like you, they buy from you. If you're sincere and you're not just acting like it's all about the dollar, like, I'd give this stuff away if I could. Seriously, and that's how I come across sounding. The foot creams, the hand creams, these items here are what is going to, these sell, the hand cream and the gloves. You can buy these gloves at the dollar store right now. These socks, I got at Dress Barn on clearance a few months ago. They were clearing out their Christmas stuff. I got these socks. These are nice socks, let me tell you. I kept some for myself. These are nice socks. They were like a dollar. Dress Barn with a coupon. They were like a dollar. Okay, and the other thing I'm gonna tell you too is something like this, something small, it doesn't have to be big. Even these this year, I'm gonna sell the sizzle of these as what we call a pillow gift. Say it's Thanksgiving Day, you know somebody is having, their wife is gonna be cooking and cleaning all week for Thanksgiving. You're gonna sell this to her husband and he's gonna sneak it up to the bedroom and he's gonna put it on her pillow when she's not looking on Thanksgiving Day, right, in the afternoon, after she's dressed and showered and downstairs. And when she goes to bed, she's gonna see it. And you can sell the sizzle of a pillow gift because that's gonna be like I appreciate you, you know, for having this nice family gathering, a pillow gift. I sell a lot of pillow gifts. Now, I wanna tell you ladies, you're gonna see people on Thanksgiving. Everybody's gonna go somewhere and have Thanksgiving with someone, family members. You could take a little demo bag, take your little bag of your stuff, little bag like this, or not with nail polish, but with your demo products. I don't see mine right now. And you're just gonna tell people, you know, we have these really amazing holiday products out this year. I'd love to, you know, who do you have on your list that you need to buy for? Or offer to sell it to them. You know, the satin hands, you can pretty much sell to anyone. And I know you might be thinking, well, it's my dinner. I don't wanna be pushy with my family. Just have a cute bag with some stuff in it and set it somewhere on the end table, the coffee table. And when you're sitting down with people having a conversation, you could say, you know, have you done your Christmas shopping yet? Like, have you started? You know, and just tell them what you offer. Just tell people what you offer. Does anyone have, oh, these here, Target, a dollar. Mm-hmm. Every single one of them sold. You could put satin hands, satin lips. You could put a miracle set. You could put whatever you want. If you have pedicure sets, some of us still have pedicure sets, whatever you want. These sold. So it doesn't have to be like fancy things. There are some things that are fancy, but you can start out with something like this. And if nothing else, just use the box that we have and just get a bag and a bell. So does anyone have any questions?
I do, Jim. I love all your packaging. Very simple, great, and easy. So tell us how you sell so much. Who do you sell to? Obviously, your customers, we got drive-by. Let's talk about how you're bold and you go to places that you frequent and that you know and business and things like that. Can you share with them a little bit about that? Because everybody here is like, okay, I'll go through my few family and friends.
Okay, I'll tell you.
I'm going to sell thousands.
I'll tell you something I started doing a couple years ago. I go to the same Jiffy Lube to get my car oil changed. And I know those guys. Like, they know you. They're in business to know you. When I pull up, they say, how are you today, Miss Stewart? Not because of this. Because they either run your tag, somehow they figure out who you are. And we need to be like that. We need to be personable like that. So when I go to get my car serviced, I always have stuff, especially around Christmas time. And I will pop my trunk when they bring you your keys and say your car's out front. And I go back in and I say, I need to see something's out there with my car. Can you please come outside? Like, seriously, they all come out because they think there's something wrong. Did I forget to put the oil cap on? What? Gushing oil in the parking lot? And I say, I just wanted to give you guys an opportunity to shop with me. Because you know I sell Mary Kay. Well, they do now. But I would just love to offer you an opportunity to shop with me. Because you guys work late. I know you want to go out and have a couple beers with your buddies after work. And you don't want to go to the mall. But y'all can't go home empty-handed. I say things like this. I'm not saying you have to be bold. And I mean, not to be like that. Like, I've said things before. Like, okay, I know you need to earn some brownie points with your wife. I know you do. Because I could just tell you're in trouble. Like, you have doghouse and all of your kids. So you need to take this home, mama. Like, I just talk like that to people. I guess I'm just, I don't know, I'm fun-loving or whatever. But I'm not afraid to walk into a bar full of half-drunk men. And I will come out with $500 in my pocket. Like, my director will test for me. She started doing it. She's like, I want to go with you when you go. I said, okay. We have to sing a couple karaoke songs to get in the rhythm. Oh, well, you have to fit in with the crowd. Tanya sang a karaoke song in Applebee's 2 years ago. I mean, you have to get people will buy from you because they like you and because you're fun and because you're real. You can go to a gas station, BJ's, Tire and Auto Center. A car wash is gold mine if you go to a car wash because there's 8 guys out there wiping down your car. Oops, my trunk popped open. Sorry. I mean, that's what you do. You just, guys, I'm telling you, Carolyn Chesky does it. She sells $600-$800 a day. Carolyn Chesky, like, really? She goes to where she does business. Where do you get your hair done? Where do you get your nails done? I will walk in. I used to do it with Karen Clapsaddle. She was the director in our area a few years ago. We used to go in the American Legion. She's like, I need to go with you. Where are we going today? It doesn't matter where you go. If people say no, they're not saying no to you. They're saying no, they're not interested. Like, if I offered everyone in here a stick of gum right now, not everybody's going to say yes. I don't care. I'm keep my gum. I'm going to keep it moving. No means next. Like, seriously. Yeah. But you just have to go where you do business, where people recognize your face and your family. Don't be afraid to ask your family. These things right here, my daughter has already taken every single one of them out of my inventory. And I'm like, you need to pay me or do your own order. Like, seriously. She's like, Mom, this is cool. These are amazing. So you just have to be a little bold. Don't be afraid to ask people. You know, just keep it real and be sincere and tell people you offer a money-back guarantee. And I'm going to tell you what. I saw on Facebook the men's coming out with the cleanser.
Oh
snap, dog. I'm all over it. Oh, I'm going to have the men's. I'm going to have to get some new bags because I'm going to be selling that to my customers. Okay, you might not feel like, you know, your customers will buy stuff from you, especially if they're already on the product. If you have a woman on a miracle set, she'll buy one for her sister. Yeah. Just ask.
I have a question,
Jim. Real quick, just so you guys know, AC Moore is honoring you if you are military. So they will give you big time military discounts. So I walked in there prior to my vending event and I said, do you have military discount? He said, yeah, show me your ID. And he took off close to $20 for my order. So
these are the bags I was talking about, the candy bags.
I went to Big Lots. Big Lots is another place where you can get stuff cheap as well, and some of them are going for a buck. So you just have to go back in their Christmas store, and they have not even opened up their Christmas area yet. And if you ask the store lady, she will open up a box for you so you can get them first. And then another place, Michael's as well, had that 50% off sale on all their baskets. I went a little nuts, so I have a lot of baskets back in my house. So I'm gonna be bringing them and putting them in my trunk next Thursday. So please feel free. I mean, I'm not one of those people that's like, you gotta pay me. I'm not, no. Take the bag. Just take them out of my house. My homie's already mad. I got too many baskets in my house. So just take them. I got overabundance of ribbons. I have tons of baskets already made that I'm getting ready to go out and do another event for. So feel free.
Thank you, Juanita. Another question?
So when you walk into Applebee's, do you take a big bag of stuff?
Well, typically what I do is I have little bags like this. I will walk in. Well, this one's not so little, but I will walk in with some of these in there. Like, because this, everyone's going to stop and look at you. Like, what is she about to do with that bag? What is going on with this bag? Like, seriously. Or you could even walk in with this bag and have one or two things. If they see something foo-foo sticking out, everyone's looking at you because everybody likes that, right? And then I just have it in my car, and you can ask people to come out to the car. You know, I just happen to be in good with that Applebee's because I know them. My daughter worked there for a long time. But you go to where you go. If you go to your Applebee's, you just walk in. Well, first you got to make a connection. Call the manager. You know, we can talk about that. You know, you gotta be known. You know, you don't want to just walk in and get busted for soliciting. I mean, seriously. But if you have a connection with somebody there, you just walk in with something. I walk in with three of these in my hand, and everyone's looking at me. Everyone. Just, you want to draw a little bit of attention to yourself and just start making conversation. You know somebody. You know? Yes.
So, what do you add on top of the cost of the product for your...
So I add whatever I spend. So these beer koozies are a little expensive. I'm not saying you have to do it this year, but these are about $4 each. So I add that $4. I might not add an extra dollar for the packaging and the ribbon, you know, because you get them for pennies. But something like this, if it's more fancy, you want to add the cost for the basket. But I wouldn't add more than you spent. Because you're already making 50% on your profit. You know, your profit. Now, if you wanted to do something like this, you could add $3 or something like that. I don't add a whole lot over what I spent for packaging because I'm getting my 50% profit.
And also something too, when you're out selling cold like that, you don't charge tax.
No.
You don't get into like this cent thing. It's flat dollars. It's 10, 15,
right.
20, 25, 30, 30.
Right.
It is nothing. No tax. It is a clean
deal. Right.
You have your little propane little thing on your phone.
Right.
You swipe your credit card and you are done.
Right. And then when you come home, you can fill out your sales slip with your non-recovered sales tax or, you know, something like that for your weekly. But I would say if this is 55, I would just say 58, maybe 52, 50, you know.
I think you need to keep it round.
Yeah, because you can add non-recovered sales tax to your income taxes.
Yeah.
Yeah, but you're not going to sit there and, like Jen said, okay, 6%, this, that, you're going to lose them.
Those gift certificates?
I don't put gift certificates in mine anymore because truthfully I sell to mostly my customers, people at work, and guys.
I would put it in though.
You would?
Absolutely.
You can put.
It's redeemable only when the person who received it called you for a facial.
Right.
So you're then able to get a new customer. It costs you nothing to print them out. So I personally
right.
would put a gift card or a gift certificate for a free pampering session, maybe even like $10. But they don't get it unless
exactly.
they contact you. And then the first few steps, if you know him, like a husband or a guy, I would ask for his wife's number strictly just to follow up with her after New Year to make sure she loves her product
right.
and to pam- and get her pampered. And they will give you their girlfriend's, wife's, mom's name and number for you then to send a text of New Year, Happy New Year. I hope you love the gift that Bobby got you. We'd love to get you scheduled for your pampering session that comes along with it.
Just to add what you
so
said.
You want to come up just in case.
About, because I've done that where it's either at a promotion that I've done
or if I'm on the go selling, sometimes they don't want to give you their wife's number or whatever it
is.
That's
okay.
And that's okay. But you can say that, well, there is a gift certificate in here. If you give me her number, I can send her a reminder before it expires.
Yeah.
And I said that, and they gave me the number.
Yeah.
So I wanted some people tomorrow because, you know. So that's just an added kind of.
I brought some pictures if you guys want to look at them or take pictures on your phone of some really good ideas. Some of these are mine that I made. Some I lifted off of Facebook. I thought this one was cute with the loofah in the middle. If you guys want to take pictures. Oh, real quick, I have to show you this one. I forgot to show you. A big thing this year is, here it is. Okay, a big thing this year, they have these cute little things. Like it'll say footnotes. You can have like a journal and then put a foot cream on there and you can wrap a bow around it, put a candy cane and you can call it like footnotes. There's another one I saw like this. It had all of the eyeliners on top of a journal book for like a college student. The liquid eyeliners that we have that are 10 bucks. Okay, you can order those for $5 wholesale. You'll get your double credit this month and you can buy these journals anywhere. Michael's in the checkout line has the cute little journals. That's where I got this. This is actually a Christmas gift, and I just took it out of my office tonight to show you guys. But you can put the foot cream on top. You know, imagine that's a foot cream. You wrap a bow around it. You put a candy cane. It doesn't cost you. This was like a dollar. So you could add the dollar on. But the big thing I want you guys, don't feel like there's a lot of stuff here. You might be overwhelmed. You might be shutting down. You might be thinking, I'll do it next year. Don't think like that because you're gonna miss out. You can so easily do the socks. You can get fuzzy socks at the dollar store. You can get the gloves at the dollar store. And you don't have to buy just the holiday products to get the double credit. It could be anything. Buy the Skin Vigorant brushes. Buy the hand creams. Buy the foot creams. You will not be sorry. You will sell them. I mean, I challenge you to prove me wrong. You won't, because everyone will buy them. Teachers, people that you need to have gifts for. I know I've gone over my time, but does anyone have any more questions?
That was nice.